All right, I'm back at my bench, and today we're going to be scavenging this old phone for some parts. This was a Goodwill find. The main reason I bought this was I was interested in the carbon microphone that some of these old phones have. Hopefully we'll find one of those. I've never done this, but I want to try to turn that carbon microphone into a sort of lo-fi microphone with this receiver and everything. While we're at it, I want to crack open the body of this phone and see if there's anything interesting inside. Of course, there's probably something that's producing dial tones, producing ringing sounds, and all sorts of other things, and we'll see if there's anything useful in there for us. Again, it's an old phone, so it should be easy to spot components, but again, this is a blind run for me, so we'll see what happens. As always, we want to put safety first. Phones do plug into the wall, but they don't use the same 120 volts AC. They're usually, I think, 48 volts DC when they're ringing. When the phone rings, I believe they get maybe an AC current. Again, I'm not an electrical engineer. I'm not an expert in this, but my friends have assured me that this is a safe project to crack open. So let's have a look. Let's start with this handset. This will be pretty easy. Maybe we should start by taking off the hairband. And I'll have to remember to try to wash my hands after this too, but let's just get that. All right, ear goes here, mouth goes here, so let's open this up. All right, so immediately here's a loudspeaker. Now, most types of loudspeaker are reversible, so if you have a loudspeaker, you can turn it around and it becomes a microphone. So, man, you can see the coil of wire on this. This is kind of really neat to look at. I'm not sure what this component is. We can check that out in a moment. But just for example, this is an old project that I did a while ago. This is actually a telephone's earpiece that I hooked up to a quarter-inch jack to make this a lo-fi microphone. Let me just show you how complicated the circuit in here is. This gets wired to the jack, and that's about it. I am sure in the edit, I will wire in a sample of what that microphone sounds like, maybe here.
Hello, this is the sound of that microphone. I'm talking into it now.
It looks like I can unscrew this without cutting any wires, and I like the looks of that. Anytime I don't have to cut things, that makes me happy. So there we go. That's that out. So I think I want to keep this as a loudspeaker, although I could turn it into a microphone, but I've been working recently. I just have a little Atari Punk console here. This is basically just a couple 555 chips. If you're interested, just Google Atari Punk console, and there's a couple instructables on how to make it and very cheap parts. I've just got a little piezo speaker here. See if it's make any sound for me today. All my wires hooked up. There we go. That's very, very quiet. I'll hold that close to the microphone. Okay. That's a conversation for another day, though. Let's see if we can get this to make sound with this. So there we go. That's not bad. I can't remember what I paid for this phone at Goodwill, but there we go. We've already benefited a speaker from it. Let's have a look at that mouthpiece. Oh, okay. So just to show this, anytime I get close to the camera, it gets out of focus. There are just a couple contacts in there, and this sits on top of them. Gross. Again, should wash my hands after all this. Oh, and that just comes right out. Oh, this is going to be beautiful. So, I believe this is... I actually don't know if this is a carbon microphone. Usually, a carbon microphone has two layers of metal, and there's carbon that vibrates between them, so... I'm not completely sure about this at the moment, but we'll set it aside and we'll come back to that. If I'm going to make this microphone, I think it would be neat to put it back in the handset, because the handset has all sorts of resonances to make it sound more like a phone. Make it sound like a phone, which it is. And let's keep this place where it mounts into. And then maybe we'll end up cutting off the wires there. Oh, there we are. Yeah, this could be good fun. All right. Now, this is already loose, but let's, I don't know if that's gonna be useful at all. Let's open this up. Oh yeah, that screw. I don't think I even need a screwdriver for that. That's interesting. There's a knob here that says loud. I'm sure that's for the ringer. What do we got? Oh my goodness, look at that. I'm going to keep this. This needs some wiping down, but regardless of what happens on the inside, this could be an interesting case to use for something. I'm running out of desk space here. Okay. Oh, gross. So, not gross, but there's actually... I'm not sure I can show this. Let me see if I zoom in. So someone put a Band-Aid over one of these bells in order to make it quieter. That is loud. That's neat. I want to see what's behind this number pad here. All right. Oh gosh. So we have some chips here. So as I mentioned, I don't know what I'm doing, but we can see that the way that this phone rings is mechanical, right? It's got something that's going to move that striker between those two bells. What I was looking for here, though, is something that's going to produce the tones, like the dial tone and the other, when you push the keys, those tones. Let's have a look at these wires. So this is where the handset goes, is where it plugs in. If it's to be matched here, the red and black wires went to this speaker. And again, it makes me think that this speaker needs some power, which makes me think that maybe it is a carbon microphone. I'll have to look up some of these numbers. I would also be interested in looking up the numbers of these chips on the back here. All right, needs a wipe down, but we just got a great numpad. All right, so I'm sure there's a veteran telephone repair person who's watching this video and thinking about what an idiot I am. I'm okay with that. I'm just trying to poke my way around here and see what fun things I can do. Okay, so we got to think about a few things. There needs to be some way for the output to come off of this board, right? So if I'm thinking that this is what's making the sound, that's my guess. And I'm guessing it's this guy here. I'm not completely sure what that is. We've got to find a way to get the sound off of this. I'm also pretty sure there's got to be some voltage going on to this. I believe when a phone is off the hook, it's something like 5 volts or something around there. I might try my 9-volt battery. So my guess is that the black wire is going to be my ground. There are 2 red wires, but one of them has green stripes on it. So if I were to guess, I'm going to guess the red wires the voltage in. As for where sound's coming out, I don't know. So I'm going to get a breadboard and wire some things up and then see, start thinking about if there's a way we can think about this. My theory is this is the black and the red are where I'm going to provide power, and then either this orange or the red striped one are where the sound is going to come out. See how I did? Power. So I've got one end of the speaker connected to this orange. I'm going to wire the other end to ground. See if this works. Oh, I got it! Kind of. Alright, let's see if I can do that better. There it is. I'm holding this up to the microphone now. Oops, and now I've knocked something off. Yeah, so that is a tone generator. S2559F. Okay, well, so we got it 9 volts of power, and then we were able to turn that into an oscillator. It doesn't look like there's terribly much to play with. I'm going to pull up the data sheet and see if there's anything to do with that. The last thing that I want to do is go back to this carbon mic and see if there's anything we can do with this. So if this is a carbon mic, it needs power. It needs external power to make sound. So let's try a few things. Here I have just a 1/4-inch jack. Now, I don't want to send 9 volts into anything through a 1/4-inch jack. So there are a couple things I could think about here. Hey, there we go. Hello, 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 hello. Here it is up against the microphone. Hello, 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 hello. Hey, that sounds great. All right, I don't know. I think maybe there was a problem with my circuit board. I don't want to overthink it. Maybe you'll have caught what I did wrong in the video. So let's talk through what's happening. Battery goes to this speaker. Again, our carbon microphone needs power to work. I'll throw up a link about carbon microphones. But in that link, I've got this transformer in here that does a little bit of amplification work for me before it gets to this speaker. Now, that's all well and good, but let's now try it with an audio jack. So speaker is out. Check, check, check. This is the sound of my telephone mic. Okay, my amplifier's kind of far away there. Okay, so let's think about now installing this. This is gonna go back in here. Can my battery fit in there? Yeah, we want the battery in there, but we don't want it rattling around, right? The other parts we're gonna need, though, is we're gonna need this transformer and this audio jack. Let's see. Probably fit that one in there, but it seems like we'll want to use the microphone this way. So let's put a new hole in it. That there. Okay. Thank you. check, 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 yep. Check, check, check. Oh, there it is. Check, check, check. Wow, yeah! Ha, ha, ha. All right, that looks like we got it. Let's try it out. Where'd my battery go? At this point, you're all watching this video and you can see exactly where that battery is. And I'm like, oh yeah, I see it now. Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. All right. There's our telephone microphone. Check, check, check. Again, turn the power off. There's nothing coming out because that's a carbon microphone. But here we go. Okay. Well, we've got some things to do. I guess we should try to put together an etude. So here we go.
Nobody calls anymore, man. I don't know what to do about it. Everybody's just texting. Not that's gonna help anything. Need to hear the sound of a human voice sometimes. I miss the days of crystal clear telephone communication. It's not coming back. What are you gonna do, send me a TikTok?